Hi, and welcome to another episode of Red Talks. I am your host, Nathan Pierce. And for those of you who have been following this series, you'll notice the change of background. We have a new location. Clearly, we have a bigger budget because there's the Red Talks plant, and we even have the redtalks.live toolbox. Got some pictures to hang up in the new office. We still have our head of PR, Bella, slightly out of camera. This episode is in support of F5's big launch of the SuperNetOps training program. I've talked a little bit about SuperNetOps before. Very short version, network operations to support DevOps methodologies and practices. So it's basically about taking all of that awesome networking knowledge out there and getting it off of the CLI and out of the GUI, which might be a management tool or a web interface, whatever, and actually linking that into and supporting continuous deployment tool chains. We talk a lot to businesses and to developers, and they really want that, and they see anyone not participating as a problem, as someone to try and circumvent and maybe replace or get around. Well, we don't want to do that. In fact, we've invested quite a lot in helping people with all that network expertise evolve and become a part of the new world order and have a table at that DevOps conversation. So we provided free online self-service training. Create an account, log in, start learning how to do programmable infrastructure instead of using CLIs and GUIs, so using REST APIs. But we understand that there are things you might want to learn or might need to learn so that when you come into that training course, you're confident in kind of what a REST API is, because there are a few skills that aren't included in the course that were sort of outside of the scope. So I'm putting this short series together, the first article being called Becoming SuperNetOps Day One. So in this first article, a couple of things to just think about when you want to take on this SuperNetOps training, when you're ready to make that evolution kind of in your career and learn those new skills. The first thing is everybody starts at a different place. Don't let how maybe a peer or a colleague is progressing in their training be a gauge as to whether you're doing well or whether you've got the background to participate in this. Everybody starts from a different place. And I have found in my learnings that the moment I start comparing myself to someone else, I get a little disenchanted. I might be a bit competitive. And if I'm not at the top, at least 1%, then I kind of have to either work twice as hard or I wonder whether it was for me. Don't do what I used to do. Definitely don't compare yourself to anyone else. So the second thing is, making mistakes is not a negative thing. If you're making mistakes, then you're pushing the boundaries of the way you used to do things. There's a reason we don't learn new skills in production environments. Well, I hope you don't. Please don't. So mistakes are great. In fact, every time you make a mistake, that is how the whole continuous improvement thing works. You fail, but you quickly work out how you failed, you document it, or you modify the way things were done so that someone else won't fail in the same way. And we talk about that in this article series, so make sure you read up on that bit, how organizations have embraced not failing, but learning and adapting fast. And the third point before kind of going into this series is, you want make sure you have points along the way as part of this journey where you sit back and just evaluate how you change the way you look at things. I very much found when I started to get into programmable infrastructure that even the way I troubleshooted completely changed. Instead of myopically jumping into something, stepping back and thinking, well, maybe if I just deployed it in a totally different way, then that would stop being a problem. You'll notice an evolution changes the way you look at things, the way you approach business and apply some business aspects to the way you're doing technology will kind of evolve over time. And it's really cool to keep checking in on that as you go. It's very rewarding to see, like, you know what, I'm doing things very differently now. And hopefully you'll find that you're doing them in a more sustainable manner. So in this first episode of the Becoming SuperNetOps, day one, we're going to cover a couple of things. The first one is just understanding RESTful interfaces. So We've got a really cool video. It's actually not by myself, it's by Web Concepts. They did a great video showing how REST works, but with very popular online tools, including, communities, sites, including Facebook, Instagram, and Google Maps. In fact, it shows you how to get coordinates out of Google Maps to look at pictures in Instagram, but it's doing it programmatically through API. So I really recommend starting there because it's very well-known sources of data. It's actually kind of fun to understand how the developers who made those platforms got things to work. You start to look at sites differently and you start thinking, wow, now I know how they did that. And while it seemed like total magic, it's actually completely understandable. It's probably just a REST API call to another service that gets some data and then presents a combination of those two datas working together, those two sources of data. The second thing in this one is actually Postman. We don't expect you to just start programming. Postman's an amazing tool. Don't be turned off by the fact that all of their marketing and messaging is towards it being a tool designed for developers, for API developers. Actually, it's an amazing tool for learning APIs and just commencing your journey of interacting programmatically. So forget all of that developer messaging. March straight into Postman. It's fantastic. And then the last part in this first day one article is just troubleshooting JSON. When we start working with APIs, you'll see very quickly how just a misplaced comma just breaks the whole thing. And that's fine with very small amounts of data. But once you start interacting with larger data sets, finding that comma can be difficult. And we're going to show you really easy ways to validate the JSON schema that you're using so that we can sidestep all of that needle in a haystack work that you just don't have to do. So that's the first article. We're going to move on to more advanced themes in future articles in this series, maybe day two or day three. Introduce some things like working with GitHub. It's really cool once you take that first step. I even do my note taking in a repo now instead of using typical collaboration tools. You may become obsessed like myself, and some basic scripting stuff as well. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this article. I hope it's really useful. We in no way expected everybody to be at the same level to start the Super NetOps training at the same time. So these are resources for the people who just need to look at a few tools and maybe get some background first to make it available to everybody. So this is Red Talks episode 24, I think we're up to now. I'm your host, Nathan Pierce. Thanks for listening. I'll do some work on this, maybe move the toolbox for future episodes. That's my 10-year service at F5 Plug back there. It's a year and a half old already. Great. Thanks for listening. I hope you enjoy it. Cheers, guys.